Experiments all involve measurements. If those measurements are off, the experiment's results may be invalid. They're certainly not reproducible. Calibrating and validating our instruments can help to ensure that our measurements are precise and accurate. And that's the topic of this module in experimental design. This applies to all measurements, both physical and behavioral. Weight scales, for instance, need to be checked against known standards to make sure that the results they're giving are accurate. They need to have those measurements repeated time and again to make sure that they're precise. If you're using more than one scale, you need to make sure that they all give the same reading. The same goes for human activities in the lab. Many experiments involve measurements taken by people. They must all be trained and checked against each other to make sure that they are both precise and accurate as well. If you hire a new graduate student in the lab, measurements not only depend on the physical equipment they use, but also the way in which they employ it. After training, they must be observed while measuring some standard or performing some preset task to see if what they get is accurate. They must do this repeatedly to ensure that they are precise. When we create a new behavioral scale, it also has to be validated. We need to make sure that the scores we get from it are accurate. Perhaps it's a measure of anxiety. We have to test it against some known standard or people with varying levels of known anxiety to make sure that the results that it gives properly represent people's mental state. We also need to make sure that it can detect changes in anxiety. This is related to precision. It needs to be tight enough in its measurement that we can rely upon it to perform research. Whole experiments need to be set up to validate new tests. In the same vein, we should only use validated tests and measures in our own experiments. That way you can make sure that others using the same tests and measures will get the same results. This is a crucial component of reproducibility. If you're not using a validated scale or measure, you have to perform that work yourself. You can't just use some new technique or instrument without showing that it's accurate and precise itself. Such work can often result in its own publications. Let's review. Use validated tools and instruments in your research. Use them in the way they were intended to be used. If you use a new instrument or tool, or an old one in a new way, you will need to perform the validation yourself. This is a critical step, and you need to describe your work clearly and thoroughly so that others can replicate it. Before and throughout experiments, you need to calibrate your instruments. Make sure, again and again, that they are performing accurately and precisely. You really can't do this often enough. More than one experiment has been found to be incorrect because the instruments making the measurements were off. This training module is part of a series funded by the National Institutes of Health.